Hi, Jonathan here. Today is 31st of January 2021. The time right now is 9:31 p.m. And it's gonna be a long YouTube, okay? But before that, first of all, tomorrow is 1st of February. The month of January just gone. February started. If you think that 2020 was a missing year, 1 month in 2021 just gone. So, what have you been doing? The market has been moving tremendously. So, are you in the market? Definitely, am I right? First of all, everyone is talking about GameStop. Everyone is talking about AMC. Everyone is talking about BlackBerry, Blueberry, whatever berry. Plus, you know the Nokia 3310 that cannot break down one? Everyone's talking about all those stock. Why? Reddit. Okay, so I'm not going to talk much about GameStop. I'm not going to talk much about all those because everyone has been doing a lot of reading. And if you'd like to find out more, there's tons of material. And every article is talking about that. Every YouTube is talking about that. So I will not talk about that. But I just want to talk a little bit about something. You will notice that the biggest news right now is David versus Goliath. Retailers won from the big boys. Retailers won this battle. But you have to understand one thing. You as an investor and you as a trader is different. Fund manager, they come and go. And in fact, it's not their money. But let's just put it this way. If you are a major shareholder of GameStop, what will you be doing right now that as of currently, the company GameStop is in the top 500. Should supposed to be part of S&P, right? So you ask yourself, what will you do if you're an owner and major shareholder of GameStop and currently from nothing, and all of a sudden you are now in S&P top 500 company in United States? You will, of course, cash out. Am I right? For those of you who do not know, GameStop is like Blockbuster. Nobody now rents video. Nobody now go and buy DVD to play the games. Well, they still do. But you notice now, even the latest PlayStation, you got an option of DVD or non-DVD. So, okay, never mind. So, look at this. Push up the price of AMC. They cash out. So, who is the real winner right here? Who is the real winner right here? You want to participate? All this says, yes, this is another one. Yeah. Just remember one thing. Don't be the last person waiting for the musical chair. When it ends, then you'll find there's no more chair. You'll be left holding it. So that's it. But I want to share with you. Right now, everyone's talking about, okay, silver. Short squeeze silver, that's the next target. So I would suggest that you really go to Wikipedia, read up this document called the Nelson Bunker Hunt. Okay, Nelson Bunker Hunt. He is no longer around. He was a billionaire and he cornered the silver market in 1980. Okay, 1980. Now let me share with you. A lot of people do not know this. A lot of people do not know this. So I would suggest you read up this document on silver, how silver market was being cornered. Why? I just put it this way. Okay, I'll just put it this way. What is the minimum age for a person to start investing? What's the minimum age? So for a person in different country, different regulations, minimum is 18, some are 21. So we can say between the age of 18 and 21. Okay? Let me ask you another question. When was the last major market crashed? No, don't say last year. Okay, yes, last year we got a bear market. But last year, because of the flu, was the shortest bear market and the shortest bull market run. In fact, the run downside and the run upside was tremendous. So we were like less than 6 months, 9 months from a bear market recovered, become bull market and super bullish. So people that are holding on don't really feel the pain. So that don't count. That don't count. Okay? But if you remember, the last time a bear market, 2021, okay, was 2007, subprime crisis. Still remember that? I won't surprise that a lot of you don't, because that happened 14 years ago. 14 years ago. So 14 plus 18, the minimum age where they first started trading, 14 years ago. So most people that saw the last crisis averaging about 32 to 35 years old right now. That's their age. Oh, make you feel old for those of you listening, am I right? So the people that actually saw the subprime crisis, assuming at the minimum age, they already started trading and investing. Right now, they are 32 to 35 years old. And you can bet a lot of people that are reading Reddit are younger than that. So what does it mean? Very simple. GameStop is a very big story that helped people get into the market. People that are not interested in the market are now interested in the market and deeply interested in the market. Plus, over it comes together with the biggest bull run ever over the last few months. And everyone is hearing, wow, this is a fantastic way of making money. So one thing for sure, a lot of people right now are interested in trading and interested in investing. And that's good news. That's good news. Why? Okay. So, do think about that. Okay. Read from the other side. And if silver do go higher, I know some of you will start criticizing. Jonathan, this will get oxidized. It already oxidized. This is like my good luck. Nothing to do. Mwah, mwah. Collector's number, collector's year, 2018, Silver Eagle. It's for me to play with it. Some of my graduates actually got this. Now cannot find. It's totally out of stock. You cannot find the 2018, or very hard to find the 2018. Because it was such a good year. The next year was everyone looking was the 2020. Okay? So. Okay, enough blabbering. So what's going on in the market? 1st of February. Tomorrow is 1st of February. Which means this is the first week of the month. And in fact, February was very unique. This February is very unique because it's a perfect February. For exactly 4 complete weeks. Perfect February. Okay, Monday to Friday. So, Monday, look at it. Nothing much except USD. United States reporting ASM manufacturing numbers, which everyone is going to watch. Tuesday, nothing much except Australia. Wednesday, nothing much except New Zealand. Thursday, we got GDP numbers. Friday will be the non-farm payroll. So, economic-wise, is somewhat quiet. But everyone is watching this. Amazon earnings, Google earnings, Disney is next week. This one is the next week, PayPal, okay? And for those of you trading in Hong Kong stocks, Ping An. So everyone is watching some of the news and also watching this one. Because they are not only the manufacturer of Viagra, but they also manufacture of the vaccine, Pfizer. So watching that very closely. And of course, no one is paying attention much to ExxonMobil. Remember, ExxonMobil used to be the biggest company in the world in terms of market share, capitalization, market capitalization. And now oil companies are just it's no longer the hot thing, but everyone's talking about EV, electric vehicle. So anyone with electric vehicle in their portfolio are all interested. Forget it. Everyone's talking about GameStop. Everyone's talking about Reddit. Okay, so never mind. So what I'm going to share with you is I know a lot of you are asking a few things. Can I still buy GameStop? I'm not going to answer all those because remember whatever I share is my personal opinion. If you'd like to trade, please do your own due diligence. If you want to get involved in all those, the only thing I can tell you is don't bet your entire house into it. And don't be the last one sitting and waiting for the musical chair to stop. Because the moment it stopped, you will be just a collateral damage. That's all I can say. Okay? Now, then another group of people that actually asked me, well, a lot of message. I'll share the Pegasus at the end. Okay? Can I still short the index because it was falling? If you remember last week, YouTube, I said already, be careful, be careful, be careful, be careful. But why after the market drop, then you think you want to short after the market drop? You know, this the thinking. When everyone goes into one direction, by the time you're thinking about going to the same direction, it's actually about time for you to get out from that direction. Okay? So, S&P. Okay? S&P. If you notice, if I draw a simple Fibonacci, there is a little bit more downside. Okay? There is a little bit more downside. So, I'm expecting that maybe Monday, we could have a little bit more downside, which is not a surprise, because on Friday, we broke. Okay? On Thursday, the market was bullish. The market was bullish. But towards end of the US trading day, this sell-off changed that bullish candle. In fact, when it was right here, I said, oh, that's a good bullish candle waiting to go higher. But as it closed the sell-down, it changed the bullish candle to become not so bullish. And on Friday, the moment we break below the low, it changed to bearish. So on Friday candle, in S&P, it is bearish. So we are expecting, personally, I'm expecting a little bit more downside. But, if you take a look at stochastic, I know I jump around, because different indicator tells you a different story. So if you use a stochastic 1433 for a longer term, you will notice that right now, look, where's the stochastic line? Closer to 20. Some of you said, no, I don't use stochastic 1433, because a lot of books tells me to use stochastic 533. Fine. 1433, 533, look at it. After such a fast fall on Friday and, of course, Wednesday, which was prior warning given, we are now reaching the oversold. So, can the market rebound? Do remember, whatever I shared is my personal opinion. If you like to trade, please do your own due diligence. So, yeah, maybe Monday, we could be expecting some downside. And if we can go downside, maybe hit close to 32, then we should be looking for a technical rebound. Can the rebound go even higher? Let's just put it this way lah. Let's do one day at a time. Why you want to predict until so far towards the future? If you want to predict so far to the future, all right, fine. I say Dow Jones, 100,000. I don't say when, Dow Jones 100,000. But what I'm saying is that, why don't you look at, understand the price action, understand what is the price doing, understand what it's going to do. So, if you take a look, Dow Jones, those are the Moneypot Light. Okay, so if you like to know more about Moneypot Light, you just go to, not this version, this version is only for Pegasus Trader. You go to Gathering of Traders, like, share, and subscribe. My YouTube also. Go to More, under Files, read the Harami and Moneypot Light candle. Understand the strategy. Understand how to read the chart. And you don't have to worry what the market behave. The only thing you need to worry is the market behaving what I am expecting? If it doesn't, you can stay away from the market. If it is, there's opportunity for you to take advantage of the market. Okay? So, right here. Okay? Dow Jones daily candle. Look at, if I draw the simple Fibonacci line. See, we are actually coming down. If let's say one or two more days downside, it's actually quite easy to hit the 38.2, which actually coincides with the this. Okay, this support right here and this resistance right here. So this line I'm watching right now is 29.170. 29,180 thereabout, or 29,200 thereabout. Okay, 29,200. So watching that, maybe 1 to 2 more days of downside, we may hit the 38, and that will be a good time. Yes, a lot of people actually also talk about this line. Let's go back to the default, and let's insert indicator trend. What's my moving average? Moving average, 50. Let's change this to green. Green. Let's change this to simple. See that? Right now, S&P is hitting the 50-day simple moving average acting as a support, but it broke. It broke. It broke. Okay? It closed below. So the next one you should be looking is, let's change this to blue. No, not this blue, this blue. Okay. Right there. See that? So remember, the moving average will continue to go higher. The FIBO 38 coincide with the, if we come closer, maybe the FIBO moving average 50 SMA may come close to the 38. So watching this, not 50, that is 100, that is 100. This is 50. 20 broke already. So watching that. Apologize if you do not understand the technical terms, but basically YouTube moving average, very useful in daily candle, 20, 50, 100, 200. So watching that, simple explanation, simple exponential are very similar. Okay, so watching that very closely. And together with that, if you remember last week, we talked about the China A50. Not only that, it's in the weekly candle. If you have taken this trade, nice profit for you. So watch out for the TP1, TP2, and TP3. This week, it's going to be a long one, a long, long thing to share. Okay, this week, if you look at all the monthly candle, understand, because well, today is end of the month, so we talk about monthly candle. Dow Jones, not so bullish, okay? S&P, don't have to talk about, will be very similar, not so bullish. NASDAQ, similar. If you take a look, London, monthly candle. Look at that monthly candle. Look at that monthly candle. Why am I excited? Because a lot of people are thinking of being in the market. That's what I'm excited. So which means, remember coming soon in about 2 more weeks is Chinese New Year. What's the color for Chinese New Year? Okay, enough excitement. If you take a look at US dollars, shoulder, head, shoulder forming. Remember, I've been talking about this shoulder, forming this shoulder? It's formed. Now, waiting for the price to break the neckline. So watching that. So which means, if you're not trading the US dollar index, you will be trading the... Not the US dollar index, you will be trading the euro dollar. Euro dollar, we got a shoulder, we got a head, and we got a shoulder. Although this pattern is not that nice, because this neckline is somewhat not a nice, horizontal. So we have that. So watching that very, very closely. And if you are not trading euro dollar, you can look at dollar yen. Dollar yen. That broke the neckline. Very nice neckline for dollar yen right there on Thursday, Friday. So look out for pullback and see opportunity right here, like Harami. Okay, right here. So we have Oreo trade right here. There was some TP right here. So that trade is done. So that's part of the Pegasus. Some of them, if you are in the Telegram gathering of traders, you would have noticed that. Okay. And another biggest news is XRP, Ripple. And this is Saturday and Sunday. That's today. The latest candle is today. everyone is pushing. Why? Because it just feels like trading is so easy as long as I read Reddit. Any stocks that appear in Reddit, everyone will be jumping in. What's the worst case? You either be rich or you just lose the capital. What's the worst case? Lose capital. Yeah. Without knowing that a lot of people are actually borrowing money as part of their capital. I don't know about you, if you still remember in 2007, when everyone used their credit card, everyone mortgaged their home and take the home loan to put into the stock market. No, that's not happening in Singapore. That's not happening in this region. That's happening in the United States right now. Because this region is not so bullish. There's no euphoria. But there's euphoria in the United States. Okay? I am excited. So February will be a very busy month. Very, very busy month. Okay? Can I finish what am I supposed to be talking about? One more. This is going to be hard to trade. It's going to be nice to trade, but it's going to be hard to trade, mainly because copper. Monthly candle. Copper monthly candle. And for those of you that know, monthly candle is, copper is a sign of economy. Read Wikipedia. We can spend your time reading what you are trading or investing. Get to know more about what you are doing. Not spend the time reading Reddit. Of course, that will be your gossip news, but so take note of that. Okay, so watching that very, very closely. Now, that's about it for the this week market analysis. It's going to be I'm watching for a technical rebound, but I'm expecting a little bit more downside before technical rebound comes in. It may come tomorrow, but if it gets lower to about 38 Fibonacci 38%, that will be a good place to start watching out for a technical rebound. That's what I'm looking at, mainly because the market right now is oversold. It's come down too fast. We need a technical rebound for the market to go even lower. If it goes even lower. Do remember, whatever I share is my personal opinion. So now let's talk about Pegasus. I'm surprised. So many response. I'm surprised. Okay, if the response still continue like what I am, maybe I may have no choice but to limit the number of people participating in the very official first batch. There are already a few batches test run already. Okay, but this will be the official first batch. And it is Zoom. And my Zoom is the extended big, not the free, not the normal Zoom, but the extended. So, but I don't want to have so many grads coming in at the same time. It makes supporting a little bit hard. So if the response still continue, maybe I'll registration close and wait for the next month or next batch. We'll see. Okay, so if you'd like to know more, do remember one thing. If you've been noticing, there's a lot of Facebook fake profile. So all I'm asking you is, if you are not comfortable, message me via Gathering of Traders. Join here. I watch this group. This is my group. Any spam that are posted in this group are removed. So you know that my posting in this Facebook Gathering of Traders is me. You can drop me an email. I already mentioned, these are my emails. Already mentioned right there, if you'd like to learn more. Okay, for those of you that do not read like this, don't waste my time. That means you don't read. What for? That means whatever I said, you're not going to read. You're going to blindly go in. And good luck to you. You don't read. Okay, so not that I don't want to share it right here, because it's useless to share right here. So, am I taking advantage of the market? Well, you notice that over the last 10 months, I haven't been doing any training. The only thing I do is supporting my existing graduates for free. That's what I've been doing for the last 10 months. And a lot of them, I don't know whether they like it or don't like it. You can ask. I don't like to spend time doing marketing. So it took me a long time just to write this simple thing, which I think this is it. I just write and I know my blabbering. So what you will get, very simple, you will get the a real-time trade alert that is different from the gathering of traders. You will get different trade signals. Some are similar. Hammer shooting star will still appear because hammer shooting star is part of the foundation of chart reading. So one of the topic will be hammer and shooting star. So it will be part of a new group of Telegram where you will get different type of trade alerts. Okay, different from the gathering of traders. You will get, let's just put it this way, your biggest worry right now if you join this group is do not know what to trade. It's not, don't have any idea what to trade. Your biggest worry will be there are too many trades. So that's what we'll be covering. What trade should you be taking? Okay, so if you'd like to know more, if you'd like to know the tuition fees, drop me an email or send me a Facebook message via this profile. In Gathering of Traders. If you see this profile outside of Gathering of Traders, I have no idea if that's me. And if you decide to transfer your money or transfer your funds or transfer anything, good luck to you. That's all I can say because you do not read. So if you'd like to know more, let's just put it this way. My graduates have been happy over what I've done for them over the last few months. So let's see, you like it or don't like it. It's up to you. Don't like it, you can always, don't bother. Okay, so my marketing is crap. Okay, let's just put it, I don't spend money on marketing. Okay, all right, that's the easy part. So bottom line, market could be going lower. World indices hopefully can get lower. We hit the 38 and I'm watching for a technical rebound. And let's see whether February will be a very nice Chinese New Year color. Jonathan, signing off till next week. Or till this Wednesday. Bye.